here I come, I wanna follow where you're leading me. Time to let go, it's sink or swim now.
We can ever do for our heroes is remember them and remember what they did, and memories are transmitted through words.
Ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country.
Centerpoint Church. We are so excited that you guys joined us today. It's going to be a great day. The Bible says, I was glad when they said to me, let us go to the house of the Lord. And I know we're online right now, but you know what?
We are in your house with you.
We're all together.
The Lord is in your house. We're doing it. We're connected.
It's fantastic.
It's 2020 though, so things have to shift. Things change.
Plans are changing this year. That's what's happening.
Probably pretty accustomed to it though.
Yeah, it's pretty normal. And the best way that you can stay up to date on what does change or what gets rescheduled or anything like that is to follow us on our social media. We have Facebook and we have Instagram, and we post everything right there. So if you were following us on social media, then you knew that we were just going to be online today.
Exactly. You were prepared.
So you were already
make
ready.
Make sure you're following us. We want to keep you updated.
With the events that are going on here at Centerpoint Church, though, we have made it so, so easy for you to be able to know about them and get signed up.
Yes, you need to go to the church app or the website. On there, there's an events tab. You click there, you register, you get connected. It's so easy.
Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. One event that we do want to highlight for you guys today is baptisms. They are coming up here in a couple of weeks, and we want you to sign up. If you've ever thought about getting baptized, today's the day, sign up.
In the river though, it's gonna be really, really cold.
It would be cold if we were doing it in the river, but we have a facility. It is gonna be nice and warm and indoors, and it's gonna be a really wonderful place. So if you've ever thought about that, if you haven't been baptized and you wanna get baptized, today's the day, sign up.
Yes, and this isn't an alone sort of event.
Like,
please invite your friends, invite your family. Let's celebrate this together.
Everybody, bring them all. Church, we're so excited for today. And before we get into the word, I just want to pray for us today. Lord, we just thank you for this day, Father. We thank you for your word, and we thank you for your faithfulness, Lord. Lord, I just ask that every person right now that is watching this, listening to this, whatever timeline they may be watching it in, Lord, that you would bless them, that you would give them ears to hear and hearts to receive right now in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Church, let's get ready for the word.
Good morning, Centerpoint Church, church family, and all of you that have joined with us online today. So glad that you can be a part of our service today. I feel I have a word that I just want to speak. I want to encourage you in your family, in your life, wherever you're at today. So let's just open our hearts and let's just dive right into the word. Let's get right into it this morning. Galatians chapter 6, verse 9. Galatians chapter 6, verse 9. I encourage you to get your Bibles, a pen and paper. You can take some notes right where you're at there today. Galatians 6, 9, it says this. This is a familiar scripture. We've read it probably many times in our life, but I believe it's speaking loudly to us today. It says this. So let's not get tired of doing what is good. Have you ever been there before? I have. There's been times in my life that I've just been tired and weary, trying to do the right thing, doing good. But it doesn't stop there. It says, at just the right time. In other words, if we don't get tired, if we don't get weary, if we don't give up of doing good, it says at the right time, we will reap a harvest of blessing, a breakthrough. Whatever area in your life that you're facing, maybe the area that you've been weary in or wanted to give up in, I'm saying to you today, the Word of God is speaking to you, is speaking to your circumstance. It's saying, just at the right time. There's been times when I've honestly let go and I've given up, when the pressure's on, or it just seemed like, man, it's intense. It just, there's no hope. And I've walked away from it, and at times I've regretted that decision. I was right at the door of breakthrough and of blessing. You may be there today. The pressure might be on. You may be tired and weary. Maybe you've even given up. But I want you today to take a hold of this verse, amen, and begin to take it into your spirit. And just at the right time, we will reap a harvest of blessing, a breakthrough of God's very best. But here's the key. If we don't give up, that's the key. So the word that I want to say to you today, I want to speak to you today, is don't give up. I want you to hear that word today. Don't give up. There's a man, there's a woman, there's a young person, somebody today. You may be right on the verge of wanting to give up in a given circumstance in your life or a situation. I'm telling you today, I'm looking right at you and saying, don't give up. 1 Corinthians 9:24, when you read the word, do you not know that in a race, all the runners run? When I was a young man, I used to run in track and field in college and through high school. And I can't ever remember a time that I got on the line with the purpose of, I'm gonna win this, I'm gonna run this race to lose. Absolutely not. It says here, do you not know that in a race, all runners run, but only one gets the prize? Run in such a way as to get the prize. In other words, don't give up. Don't give in. Don't let the best you've done in life or the best that you've done in the past be the standard for the rest of your life. I'm telling you, don't give up. You may have had a lot of great experiences in the past. Yesterday, years have passed, rightfully so, but don't let those become the standard to where today you just might say, I'm just giving up. Don't let that be the standard for the rest of your life. I believe the secret to a breakthrough is follow through in your life. Don't let worry take hold of your life, because what worry does, worry causes us just to look around and to worry about every situation, everything that's around us. Regret causes us to constantly look in the past, look behind us, always looking in the rearview mirror. But today I want to encourage you. I want you to embrace faith. And what faith does, it causes you to look forward. It causes you to look ahead what God would have for you. People that succeed are willing to confront discomfort, distractions, and doubt in spite of what they're going through. They're willing to face that. They're willing not to give up. They're willing to look at discomfort right in the face and say, you know what? I am not going to give up, but I'm going to embrace the faith and look forward. It's common that we want to quit. Like I said earlier, there's been times in my life I gave up, I quit. It's common. You look in life and leaders at times quit leading. Husbands and wives quit their marriage. People give up at times on their dreams. People give up and even their relationship with God or going to church, and the list can go on and on. There's a difference though in wanting to quit and actually quitting. I've had the thoughts many of times of wanting to quit, but down inside my spirit, the Lord speaking to me and saying, no, you've got to push through. I'm with you. I am for you. Jesus may have wanted to quit, but guess what? He did not give up. I can only imagine what Jesus endured for the sake of our lives. He did not give up and quit on you and I. But he did something that was so profound that he gave his life. He was beaten. He shed his blood on the cross. He was mocked. He was laughed at. I'm sure there were moments that he thought, I wanted to quit, but he did not. In fact, in the garden, he prayed that prayer. Father, not my will, but your will be done. You have a course to finish just like Jesus did. Jesus has a plan for your life. You have a course to finish. There's a life God wants you to live. An influence he wants you to have. So I want to encourage you today. You may be weary. You may be tired. You may be tired of the circumstances and the things that are going on in our nation and in our world. Maybe you're dealing with things personally in your life, just your job, your relationships, your marriage, your family, whatever it may be, your career, whatever it is. And you just, at that point, you're just weary and tired and you just want to give up. Let me give you some things today. Begin to set right now today some standards from the Word of God that will set up some accountability, that will set up some parameters in your life, that when those thoughts and those feelings come on, that you have a standard in place that will cause you to rise up and to keep moving forward. And I encourage you, set those standards of the Word of God in your life and work according to them, not according to your moods and your feelings. Feelings are real, but are not necessarily reality. I just don't feel like it, or I feel this, or I feel that. I want you to begin to work toward and open up your heart and not just make decisions and react on feelings and move, but begin to listen to the voice of God. What is God speaking to you? Put aside the feelings. What is God wanting to speak into your life today? Where is your expectations of God? Is God just somebody that you believe in, that you know of, that you've heard of, or it's a secondhand conversation that you've had with somebody? Or is he someone that you know? Believing is the beginning, but having that personal relationship, experiencing God, his presence, knowing him, where is your expectations of God? I believe the answer to that lies in either of these two areas, believing and knowing. My heart is today that, yes, we believe, but we don't remain there, but we take it to knowing him on a personal level, that we experience him through our prayer, through our devotion, our everyday life, our walking out our life with him, our communication, our prayer with him, having an intimate relationship with him. Or some people may have their expectations are, their knowing of God is just someone that's nailed to the wall as an idol, as a cross, him on the cross. They've left him there. I'm telling you today that God is alive. He is well. He is for you. Amen. And there's nothing more than He wants you to know Him on a personal level, intimately. Amen. That's His heart. That's His desire. James 33:3 says, call to me and I will answer you. Amen. That's that knowing. That's that intimate relationship that we can go to Him, that we can call to Him and I will answer you and tell you great and unsearchable things you do not know. God's a big God. We can be weary and tired at times. We may want to give up. But if we hold true, if we stay in the game, amen, that we can go to Him and He can show us, He can deliver to us, He can bring us things that we don't even know. That's how good He is. In tough times, we have a tendency a lot of times to lower our expectations. We want to give up, we want to give in. It may not be going exactly the way that we think or whatever. But at the right time, if we don't give up, I'm encouraging, don't lower your expectations of who God is and what He wants to do in and through your lives. And as a result, when we do, we end up a lot of times settling for less than what God wants for us when we lower our expectations. A lot of times we settle for good when God is saying, come on, I have great for you in your life today. I have something new that I want to reveal to you, that I want to give to you if you don't give up. A lot of times the pressure's on and it seems like, man, we're just tired and we are weary and we don't have any more strength and we're just like hanging on. A lot of times it's just kind of like right at that moment when we feel like we just want to give up and just let go and give in, turn around and walk away. We're right at the door of a breakthrough that God wants to give and reveal and to show us and to bless us. Don't settle for less than what God has for your life. The Bible says in Genesis 18:14, we know the story of Sarah, but I want to read this verse. It says, then the Lord said to Abraham, why did Sarah laugh and say, will I really have a child now that I'm old? Here's Sarah is now an old lady. God had spoken and said, you're going to have a son. You're going to have a child. It goes on in the verse and says, is anything too hard for the Lord? I will return to you at the appointed time next year and Sarah will have a son. I want to go back to that verse and that question that was asked. Is anything too hard for the Lord? And obviously the answer that a lot of times we give is no, absolutely not. Nothing is too difficult for God. But what you do next proves whether or not you actually believe it. We can answer no, but in actually, do we live that out? It's proven in how we react and in what we do. Let me ask you today, do you believe? Do you have the faith? Jesus said in John 13:17, it says, if you know these things, blessed are you if you do them. If you know these things, blessed are you if you do them. Amen. There's something that I know that I know. I know that God is good. I know that He is real. I know that He is alive. Amen. I know He wants to do good things in your life, in your situation today. Amen. You may be weary, you may be tired, but at the right time, blessing will come if we do not give up. To walk in God's blessing every day, you must do what He tells you. Amen. God honors and rewards obedience. He loves you today. He cares for you, and He will honor your obedience today. What is God talking to you? What is God saying to you? What is God telling you to do? I want to encourage you, don't give up. Amen. Begin to draw from His strength, because when we are weak, He is strong. It isn't by our power, it isn't by my might, but it is by His that you will achieve, that you will go to the next level, that you will have your breakthrough, you will receive your miracle, healing in your life. And at times, he may tell you to do some things that look different than maybe what you had thought of. At times, he may ask you to do things that maybe you weren't feeling. Maybe you were feeling a completely different area, a different situation, or something totally different. At times, you may feel that, you may sense that, but I'm telling you, God is always right, and he'll come through right at the right time if you don't give up. Too often we get attracted to methods which worked in the past, and we keep going back to them over and over and over, and we don't see the results. We want to give up. We want to give in. There's a statement I've always said, when is the last time you've done something for the first time? God has something new for you. When you're always looking to the familiar, guess what you do? You limit God. When you always look to the familiar, when you always look to the things maybe that I can do. But the Word says that his thoughts are higher than our thoughts. His ways are higher than our ways. The heavens are higher than the earth. He has a perspective about you and your life and what he has for your life that you don't even have. When you're always looking to familiar, you limit God. Don't give up. Right now, today, take the limits off and allow God to take you, amen, where he desires, the place that he has for you, that is right for you, that is good for you. He's much greater than your proven methods. We can come up with all kinds of things, but he is much greater than your proven methods. The Word says, call to me, and I will tell you things you do not know. There's things that God wants to share with you. You call to him. It goes on in the Living Translation, Living Bible, it says, I will tell you some remarkable secrets about what is going to happen. Amen? It's not time to give up. God has more. There's things that you haven't experienced and haven't, that God wants to reveal to you today in your life. I love the story of Moses in the Bible. And God chose Moses to lead the children of Israel out of captivity, out of Egypt. Moses never questioned God's ability. But the thing he did, he questioned his ability. He questioned whether God could really work through him to lead the children of Israel, amen, out of bondage and into the promised land. And I love the answer that God gave Moses, because Moses came up with all the different excuses. I can't talk right, this or that. I'm not articulate here or whatever. He came up with all the excuses. You need to go try to find somebody else. But I love the answer in Exodus 4:12 that he spoke into Moses' life. He says, now go, I will help you. Now go, I will help you. Maybe you've given up. Maybe you've just been weary and tired or whatever. The Word of God today is saying, now go. In other words, get up. I will help you. What he spoke to Moses said, he said, now go, I will help you. Speak and will teach you what to say. In other words, God's right there. He's with us. Don't give up. Don't give in. Today's your day to get up. And God is saying, I will help you. I will be with you. I will teach you. That's the kind of God we serve. God is neither enhanced by your strengths or inhabited by your struggles. You say, well, man, my struggles are just so big. I mean, God's not overwhelmed by your struggles. God isn't even concerned in a sense by your struggles. He is more than able today, whatever it is that's causing you maybe to be weary and tired, I want you today to release it to God. Amen? Take a brand new step today and purpose in your heart. Man, I've come close, but I am not giving up. There's more that God wants to do through you than what you've ever experienced so far in your life. grateful and thankful for the things that you've experienced, but there's more that God wants to do. So today I want to encourage you. I want you to elevate your expectations of God in your life. I want you to lift up your expectations of God in your life. Have high expectations of God and respond in faith whatever He tells you. Respond in faith. Don't doubt. Respond in faith today, amen, of what He's telling you, what He's guiding you, what He's leading you. Don't give up. 2 Timothy 4:7. Well, let me say this before I go there. Your breakthrough is right in front of you. Your breakthrough is right in front of you, not right behind you. It's right in front of you. I encourage you to lift up your expectations today for what God has for you. Yes, you may be weary and tired, and we all get there at different points and times, but God is greater. The word says, greater is He that is in me than he that is in the world. Don't worry. Don't just spend your time looking around and let worry control your life or the past. Amen. Grab a hold of faith. Embrace the faith, the Word of God. Get some standards in your life that will cause you to rise up and move forward, amen, into the things that God has for you. Your breakthrough is right in front of you, not right behind you or in your past. Don't give up. There's one last scripture that I want to read to you in 2 Timothy 4:7. This is the prayer that I'm praying that we all declare is this: I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept my faith. What that is saying there is, I have not given up. When I've gotten knocked down, I've got right back up. Amen. God is for you today, that God is with you. There's a lot of things today in life that can pull us down, that can cause us to be weary, that can cause us to be depressed and want to give up and just let go. But I want to declare that scripture over you again in Galatians 6:9. So let's not get tired. Let's make up your mind right now. Let's purpose that. Let's not get tired of doing what is good. When you sow seed of good, you will reap good. The word says at the right time, you sow bad seed, you're going to reap bad seed in your life. Let's together, amen, let's sow good. Let's do good. Even when we're maybe tired and weary, let's continue on, because at the right time, God's timing in your life, that breakthrough, that victory, that promise that you've been looking for, that God will bring into your life if you don't give up. He's a good God. Man, there's a lot of stuff right now that are bombarding us. People giving up in life. I've heard stories of just some sad situations of just people letting go, giving up in different aspects of life and their relationship with God, or even life itself. I'm telling you today, that's a lie of the enemy. God is life. He has purpose. He has a plan. There's a mission He wants you to fulfill. Just like He sent His Son Jesus, amen? He did not quit, amen? I'm sure there were moments and times that it was difficult and the pressure was on, but at that time, amen, God's strength will see you through to victory. Let's pray together. Father, Lord, I thank You today for Your Word. I thank You for our time together, Lord Jesus. I pray, Lord, that this word, oh Lord, would just be deposited into the hearts of everyone that's listening today. There are people, Lord, that may have given up. There are people may on the verge of giving up. They're just tired and weary of just all the stuff, all the things going on. But God, You're a good God, and Your word is true, and Your word gives us life. It gives us hope. God, and it says at the right time, if we don't give up, Lord, even it can be the darkest moment, it just seems impossible, Lord, knowing that you're there and you will see us through. You will give us hope. You will give us the answers. You'll give us the victory, Lord Jesus. That's where our faith lies. It's in you, Jesus. A lot of things that we can attach our lives to and attach our hopes to, but God, there's nothing that compares to you, Lord. You are the answer. I pray, Lord Jesus, that we take hold of this and we rise up, Lord, and we live our life in a way, God, that brings honor and glory to you. Even in the difficult time, Lord, you're there, God, and you will see us through. There's victory in you. There's hope in you. There's salvation in you. There's healing in you. There's restoration in you. There's victory in you, Jesus. I thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. I encourage you, church, just to open up your hearts right now. And let's just go into a time of worship. Amen. Just let this word just settle in our spirit. And let's just give our attention to him right now. Amen. And worship him with all of our heart. We love you. We're praying for you. Let's worship.
Magnificent Father, our brilliant Creator, exalts you higher. spoken. Liberty, Christ in me, chains are broken by the word you spoke.
Thank you guys so much for joining us for Church Online.
If you have any prayer requests or praise reports, please put it in the chat, send us an email, give us a call. We would love to hear from you.
Also, if this ministry has been a blessing to you and you'd like to give to support it, all of the information is down below. We love you guys. We're praying for you guys. Have a great week.
We'll see you next Sunday.